Have we got any dog lovers in here? Chin out if you're a dog lover. Any cat lovers? Nobody gives a fuck. Fucking hate cats. You know what cats are? Shit dogs. You know, like all them creatures that weren't good enough to be dogs, they became fucking cats. That's what happened, right? They're like Tesco value dogs, right? Think about it, you go home, you see your dog's like that. Wee-hee! I missed you today, let's have a good time, let's play, yeah! You come back to your cat's like that. Feed me, I'm going out. So I got a dog recently. I got a dog for my little son because my little son's, he's deaf and blind. I like to drop that hand grenade really early in the show just to see people's reaction. It's all right, he can't hear us. Now,
because he's not here.
His name's Bo, he's 3 years of age, deaf and blind, wanted to get a little... Do you like that name, did you? I'm glad you had a little conversation about him, thanks. 18 and out for the first time. The normal rules of social engagement don't apply. So, thought we'd get a little dog for Bo, right? Got a Havanese dog. Anyone ever heard of a Havanese dog? No, you know why? Because they're fucking rare and fucking expensive, right? This is how messed up our society is. We had to go and have a meeting with the dealer. It's definitely not called a dealer, is it? What are they called? A breeder. That's what gay people call heterosexual people. That's really weird. I called her a dealer. No wonder she looked confused when I said I only wanted a quarter of it. Right. So we had to go and see this breeder, right? This is how messed up our society is. We had to go and see her to have an interview with her for her to decide whether we were good enough to let us give her $2,000. What the hell's going on? So dog's called a Havanese dog, right? It's called a Havanese, perfect dog for a child with special needs. Also the perfect dog for my wife, because every time my wife goes in a shop, she goes, I'm Havanese, I'm Havanese, I'm Havanese, and I'm Havanese. If you don't know what the dog looks like because you ain't never heard of it, let me break it down for you. You probably know because you've been down to Colombia, right? Right, it comes from Havana. That's why it's Havanese, right? See what I mean, right? Like, so, by the way, what's your name? Is it Angus, right? For anyone who's never been to Australia, let me tell you where Angus actually lives. Fucking nowhere, right? No, I ain't even lying. Australia is the most amazing country in the world where they put all the good stuff around the outside, wouldn't it? And then jack shit in the middle, right? It's like a kid doing a jigsaw that just got fucking bored after done the outside. Fucking leave it. Let's put that rock in the middle, it'll be all right. Now, so Havanese dog, right? It looks like an Ewok off Star Wars. Right? If you don't know what Star Wars is, fucking watch it. Now, it's like a little teddy bear, right? It's called Hugo. Cutest thing you ever did see. Now, but yeah, oh. Right? We'd had him about 3 weeks, which makes him about 3 months old, right? So he's about that sort of size of fluff, and he had constipation. Now, I don't know how to deal with dog constipation. I'm not a dog. I know how to deal with human constipation because I have children. Brown sugar in warm water, pump the legs, no problem. Right? Don't know how to deal with a dog. So I rang the vet. I rang the vet and I went, my dog's got constipation, or as I've now called it, dogstipation. What do I do? And he went, don't worry. Just bring the dog into us. We'll sort it out. No problem. I went, all right then. So I picked the dog up. And at this point, the dog became slightly less constipated than...
Yeah, man. It's a dog shit on me, right?
Now, here's the thing. My wife has a very sensitive gag reflex. No, not like that. She could do that all day. Very sensitive gag reflex, which is activated by the smell and sight of shit, specifically of the canine variety. So as soon as I've got shit on my new jumper that I got from exec, my wife's like that. Now, I too have a sensitive gag reflex. Mine is activated by other people gagging. And mine forms two stages. Stage one is the golem. And stage two is the Swahili Maasai warrior. So mine has gone like this. Mahinga na manga nenga, mananga nenga, manga nenga. And at that point, I squeezed the dog. And a little bit more shit came out. So my wife's gone, I've gone full Gollum by this point. I'm like, my precious. I even reached that point where, you know, when you're being sick, like a group of lads out, you've done this, right? You know, when you're being sick and there's no sick left, you ain't got nothing left in your body. And the only thing that happens is your tongue tries to escape from your body and your body shakes and you make no more sound, right? I got to that point where I was like, Now, this is the point in the story where I need to tell you that we're going to take the dog to the vet. We're going to go in my wife's car. Now, my wife drives an American car, which means it's shit, right? Like most American things, it's fat, lazy, and doesn't do what it's supposed to do when it's supposed to do it. So you can't drive my wife's car in the wrong gear. I know what you're thinking. Drive it in the right gear, then I'm nuts. No. It's not as simple as that. We've all done it, right? You're driving your car. You're in third gear. You're approaching the traffic lights. They're on red. It goes to amber. You think to yourself, ooh, I might be able to get through this without going down into second gear, thus prolonging the life of my gearbox. You do it. You're winning at life. Can't do that with my wife's car, right? Because when my wife's car is driven in the wrong gear, it shakes like this. As a result of this, she no longer wants to drive the particular Mahuta vehicle that we're talking about. So she says to me, you're going to have to drive the car. I'm like, cool. If I drive the car, you're going to have to hold the shit dog. So I pass my wife the dog. And when she gets the shit covered dog on her, she has all of a sudden gone, and got sick in the footwell of the car and dropped the dog. And then the dog started eating the sick. And my wife's gone, and I've gone, now, because I'm doing that, I forget to change gear. And the car goes, there's shit and puke flying all over the car. Now, if this wasn't a true story, there'd be a really big punchline build-up at the end of it. But it is a true story. So the punchline is, and then we got the dog fixed, and then my wife... and then my wife got a new car. And then I just paused for the applause. Yes, this is fun!